Hey, this is Taylor coming to you at Major Outdoors with another video, and these are my top fish producers for springtime. Realize I didn't say I like throwing them. I like throwing some of them, but some of them I'm not a big fan of throwing, but these are probably my top five fish producers. And I'll link all the baits I used and trailers in the comment section below, so if you want to pick any of this up, that's great. And then Omnia has a lot of this stuff too, right here, and they sponsored this video. So if you want 20% off your first order, use Husky20. I'll also link that in the description below. So let's start it off with the all-time most versatile way to catch a bass. Good old-fashioned jig. This is a half-ounce Terminator Pro Series jig. It's got a little rattle on the backside of it. It's got a stout hook, and then all I did is I paired it up with a Green Pumpkin Rage Menace. I'm also going to be going from, on the groove settings, I'm going to go from clear to dirtier water. So this is my clear option normally. You know, this is a skipping, you know, it's an Arky style jig, but you can skip it. You can also swim it a little bit. I like it, you know, skip it under, and then once you're getting out of your target cast and just swim it back, see if you have any followers. Next one is a Premier jig from, I'll link it in the description, but this is a half ounce. And I really like this, you know, it's a swim jig. It comes through cover a little bit better. And then I got it paired up with a Game Changer Eliminator. It's more or less just a big Mr. Twister tail, but I really like it because, you know, with your swim jigs, a lot of them have that flatter head now. You see that? And then this makes it really easy to skip around cover. You know, it's got a flat bottom, skips under a lot better. Next one, Outcast. Cage Fighter jig just hit the market from Seth Fighter. Tungsten jig, love it. I think this is a 3/8 size and it's got the head size of a Finesse quarter ounce. And then I got it paired up with something else I love that I just broke off on a big one the other day. Is a 3.5-inch Ripper from Mossy Creek Tackle. Love it. You know, you can swim it back. You know, it does more than one purpose than just flipping around cover. You can swim it back as well, which I like. Next thing we're going to talk about is the old-fashioned, something I don't like throwing, but I throw because I catch a ton of fish on it, is a good old-fashioned shallow crankbait square bill. I got two colors here. I believe both of these are from Lucky Craft. Don't quote me on it. I got this one, really like this one in clear water. You know, I fish around central Minnesota a lot, spring fed, clear. You can see 6, 8, 10 feet down. You know, it's translucent. It's got blue, a little bit of orange on the belly, and then green pumpkin, solid. You know, they got rattles in them too, so, you know, they make a little bit of noise. Then I got this one. You know, this is probably your classic one right here. It's just a red, you know, square bill. I mean, you throw these around riprap, and you're going to catch fish. That's it. Next thing. This thing's been on the market for a little bit of time. I mean, it's a fish producing machine all year long. And that is a good old fashioned chatterbait. Okay, I got two pairs. So this is my Clearwater one. This is like a perch color, I'd say. You know, it's got a little bit of orange, but mostly green, a little bit of purple. And I actually got it paired up with a ExoSwim from Biospawn Lures. I like this. It's got a little bit of rib, so the water slowly rides this, and then until it hits the tail, gives it a little more action. I like the thumping chatterbaits earlier in the season than something like this. But don't get me wrong, you can run a black and blue all day long with this thing, with this trailer, the Razor Shad, and you're gonna get bit. Don't get me wrong, but I just feel like the thumping gets a little bit bigger fish to bite. So this is just a black and blue Z-Man Razor Shad. And realize, don't get me wrong, I love the $17 chatterbait. It works, don't get me wrong, but I don't really throw it when I'm going out to, like, I don't throw it if I'm not in a tournament setting. So I just use the normal chatterbait original. These are like $7 a piece. I like these. They still catch fish, don't get me wrong. Next thing, this is also something I'm not a huge fan into throwing. It's just something I don't like. That's a good old-fashioned jerk bait. You know, I have two types here. I got the fashion, old-fashioned shad wrap or shadow wrap. And then this is the ripstop. You know, this one's a little bit newer, and I'm going to tell you what I like about them. This one's got a little more of a classic action. Comes in perch, great colors. And I like to fish this one for largies normally. It's got a bigger body, bigger profile, classic action. This one is a clown color, is what I think it's called. You know, it's bright. It's got this back tail on it. And that gives it kind of a, you know, it cups the water coming through the water and pivots a little more funny. It's got a little more erratic action. And I like this one fishing for those bronzebacks in the river. You know, doesn't go very deep, but in the riprap, it looks really good, catches a lot of good water, and you can get those, you know, those smallies to bite when they're not, you know, keying in on, you know, the average jerkbait. And, you know, the last thing, good old-fashioned topwater. Everyone loves a good topwater bite, and I put these in the same category, even though they're not the same lure. I got a River to Sea Whopper Plopper, and then I got a Sugar Buzz from Strike King, and then that is paired up with a Z-Man Diesel Shad, I believe. I think both of these work really great. I like to throw the popper actually in colder water temps because you can stop it. So you can pop it and then just kill it, pop it, kill it. So when a cold front comes in and you know they were biting this, then you switch to this. But if they were biting this and they're not and it got too warm, then you switch to this. So I really like these two options. It's a fun bite. And with these 5 spring baits that I just gave you, you're going to catch more fish this summer or this spring. And in the comments section below, tell me how your fishing opener goes. I'm from Minnesota. My opener starts this weekend, and I can't wait to hit the water. See you next time.